It's the mid-90s. Virtual reality is thought to be just around the corner. Everything has an X in the name to sound cool, and the word cyber is introduced into every single sentence because the information superhighway is totally gnarly, bro! What do you do as a filmmaker to capitalize on the cyber virtual supernova? Why, you make Brain Scan, a movie about a haunted video game that makes your dreams come to terrifying life. Oh, and you cast Ed Furlong in the lead role because he's a hot new star and is destined to become the next Daniel Day-Lewis. Brain Scan is a beautiful museum of mid-90s stupidity, between Ed Furlong's already overplayed by that point disaffected teen routine, the deliriously awful killer virtual reality premise, and a soundtrack including White Zombie, Butthole Surfers, and Primus. Brain Scan is less a movie and more of a church, a most holy temple erected in resolute glory to the era that gave us the internet, Sonic the Hedgehog, and Pepsi Max. It's shameless in its attempts to be trendy, sincere in its presentation of a murderous video game, and, above all, it's perfectly enjoyable because of all that. By far, the true wonder of Brain Scan is to be found in its central antagonist, Trickster, played to expert effect by T. Ryder Smith. Just from the look of him, you know he's going to be amazing. A cross between Dio and every gang member enemy in Streets of Rage. His delicious overacting only seals the deal.
Knock it off!
If I had my way, Trickster would be up there with Freddy Krueger, Gollum, and Darth Vader in the pantheon of beloved iconic movie antagonists. Sadly, he is forgotten in this day and age, a true tragedy because he's the best. Clownish and cringeworthy in his one-liners, but with a genuine air of underlying malice, Smith gave this film a performance many would argue is far too good for it, but he most certainly makes the movie, and if nothing else, the film is wholly worth watching just for him. Smith is, himself, a criminally underappreciated actor, Brain Scan actually being one of his biggest ever roles. He's a brilliant performer that gets no due enough credit, though some of you may recognise him as the voice of Sander Cohen in Bioshock and Baron Underbite in The Venture Brothers. Yeah, he's awesome. Anyway, point is, Brain Scan is yet another of those terrible movies that I fully, freely, proudly admit is terrible. Yeah, it is. It's lame, it's tragically outdated these days, and Ed Furlong is kind of the worst, but as always, my job is to defend movies. Not say they're good. I'm here to tell you why Brain Scan is worth watching, worth defending, as a piece of enjoyable entertainment, if not a quantifiably quality one. So here's the lowdown, as quick as you like. Ed Furlong is great to point and laugh at. T. Ryder Smith is a darkly energetic actor whose appearance as Trickster is genuinely well performed and camply affable. And hey, with movies taking themselves so seriously or otherwise falling deep into the irony well these days, there's something uniquely charming about a movie that sincerely, earnestly tells the tale of a teenager who is made to murder people thanks to a crazy video game. It's just a shame that, in the year 2013, there are media pundits and politicians who think the events of Brain Scan are probably more of a documentary than a work of fiction. But hey, there's Frank Langella. Hello.
But no country western music, please. Every man has his limits.